Hola, mi gente.
That means what's up, folks, in Espanol, because I'm international like that. I didn't announce anything today, and I didn't even think I was going to be able to keep the schedule today because of life, which is, you know, there's some variables when you do things other than, you know, stream and play drums and stuff like that. But maybe one day I'll just be able to stream and play drums. Hey, who knows? Who knows? However, I'm just going to basically get on here so that I'm keeping my part of the bargain, which no one cares about but me. I mean, as a goal. So, I hope you all had a good week. I've been rearranging the studio a little bit. Just got a big old rock kit happening now. 24-inch kick, 13-inch rack, 16-inch floor, less cymbals. I'm actually even going to get rid of the side games here, all the electronics and the rotos, because I really need to clean the studio up. It's a disaster. And for me to say that in the situation that, in the condition that it's in right now, is pretty unbelievable, because it has been so much worse than this. Anyway, last time I had a concrete plan, and then life got complicated. Had to get a little work done on the car, had to get some new brake pads, and it's Yoda's birthday, and me and my puppy have been drinking all day, so I don't know what to do with myself. A kid, of course. If anyone wants to engage on any level, I would appreciate the help, because I have no plan for today but to last minute say, hey, I'm going to come on and talk, you know, some smack about the gear that's been changed out, which is not really that exciting for most people, unless it's exciting for you. If you have any questions on the gear, happy to answer them. If I could figure out how to take comments on Restream, because it's a work in progress and I have no idea what I'm doing. But I'm having fun doing it, which is the important part, I think, me thinks. Posted a video yesterday on IGTV of me playing over an iTabla track that was in Shibatal, which I also covered on the Playing in Nine podcast last time, and I got a pretty good response on that. That particular 9-8 is fun for me because it's subdivided in such a quirky manner. Not really that quirky, but like if you think about it in total nerdology, like 4-8 and 5-16 twice, but which is really just 4 and 5, but the 5 is chopped up into a very small denomination, 16th note denomination. So that's the way that I conceptualize that. Whatever works, you know? Whatever works, folks. There's no real set rules. Looking forward to getting that stimulus money, hopefully. And I hope better days are ahead. Seems like it. Seems like we're ahead of schedule. Hope you guys are getting vaccinated if you're able to, and not being paranoid that Bill Gates is injecting 5G sensitive microchips into all of your arms, because that would be a drag. But hey man, I'm willing to risk it. At this point, like, who cares? Like, I'll be a zombie. I'll be a Microsoft zombie. As long as I can, like, go and eat chicken wings and play music at bars, I'm happy. What else? Drink El Guapo tequila from one of the greatest movies of all time, Three Amigos. Represent. My dog Yoda is 11 today, and we thought we were going to lose him last year because he was in such bad shape around this time last year. Just started falling apart, but he rallied, and he's doing good. French Bulldog lifespan is like 10 to 14, so he's 11 today, so I'm hoping we get some more mileage out of him, because, man, am I going to lose it when Yoda goes. It's just been such a good dog, my little buddy. I usually have him here, but not today, because I've been running around without a car, but now I got my car back, so I actually was walking in L.A. today. The one person that gets that. How do I see if I am streaming on Twitch? Can I see that on Twitch, or is it through Periscope? help me out here, folks. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm new to all this. Is there a live section on Twitter? I know I see myself on Twitch. I don't see myself on Twitter. Modern problems. What's everyone doing this weekend? I am going to clean my studio, try to organize some stuff, figure out some new recording techniques, which is basically taking up every moment of my life. Not enough to learn how to play drums at a competent level, but you have to now be a recording engineer, social media guru, self-promoter, yada, 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 yada. You know, it's kind of like, all right, how many hats do I need to wear? Great. But I haven't learned this much since high school. This last year has been a lot of learning. Who's bothering me? Give me one second. Cool. Work. So yeah, what y'all doing this weekend? I'm going to be here, making it pretty. And spend time with my little girl. Maybe practice a little bit. Nothing too exciting. I really do need to get back to work. But there's something to be said for keeping a schedule. Half the time, you know, you just got to show up. I do like that video that's been going around of the older gentleman playing drums in a band, and the singer comes up and says something to him, and then the drummer, and then gives him the finger, and then the drummer proceeds to push him off stage. That really warmed my heart. There's been so many times where the only time I almost beat someone up on a gig was in Zurich, Switzerland. We were playing at this place called the Casa Bar, like a Casa Bar. And some punk-ass little, 21-year-old waif of a dude that thought he was a badass, who's probably, you know, got rich parents, came in, and he walks onto stage and he tells us to do stuff. So I stopped and I told him that if he didn't get the F off the stage, that I would kick his ass. And he got off the stage. Actually, now that I say that, that brings up another time. In Baltimore, when I was playing with this band called Prelapse, we did a record on John Zorn's label that he actually played on way back in the late 90s. And this kid, we played ballads, believe it or not. It was kind of a Naked City, chaos-based band, very loud and obnoxious, but we did play ballads. The MD was Alex Lacamoire, who's like the golden boy of Broadway. He's done Hamilton and many other things. He's a genius, and he's a little punk that I love, and I can call him a punk because he's still a little punk to me. But whatever, he's incredible. I respect the shit out of him. I'm just being silly. That being said, we were playing a ballad, and this guy in the audience just kept saying stuff. Thought he was funny, and other guys in the band were too polite. So I stopped the band in the middle of the ballad, and I told him over the mic that if he didn't stop doing what he was doing, I was going to effing kick the ass out of him after the gig. So he shut the hell up, and then we got done with the gig, and then I put him up against the wall with my forearm, and I think I might have, like Darth Vader style, like his feet might have been up in the air. I didn't end up beating him up, but I just sent a message. In the old days, you could do stuff like that. You could beat up your audience. It was great. I'm kidding. Speaking in, you know, extra, you got to make things up a little bit more exciting than they actually were when they went down. But no, that was some, those are the days. I can't do that now. If you tell someone that, you know, if you say that you don't like someone's shirt, you could scar them emotionally and end up getting canceled. So, yeah. I'm sure you guys are all wearing wonderful shirts that I would never comment on negatively. Yeah, I got nothing for you today, folks. And if I'm not going to get any questions, I think I'm just going to wrap it because I do have a lot of work to do. Not that you're not important. I love you, each and every one of you. And I appreciate you hanging out. I'm going to have something more concrete coming up next Tuesday because I'll have some time to do a little prepping. I'm going to be teaming up with my old buddy Johnny Rabb from college, and my friend Chris Burrows from Atlanta, and a few other people, and we're going to start doing, you know, drummer-based forums. Probably starting in April. There's a lot of drummers on Twitch that are doing similar things, but the idea is guys that have kind of been around a little bit longer and have more war stories and practical application of things other than playing along with, you know, the soundtrack to Fortnite. I'm being facetious and, you know, get off my lawn, but you know, the point is like, we, you know, road stories, gear issues, how do you react in this situation, what's it like, you have to, you know, travel to Asia and get off the plane and go to the venue and you don't know what time it is and you're, you know, you're a zombie and all of those things and none of them, and many things that I didn't just mention. I have no idea what's going to go down when we do those forums, but between the four or five of us that's going to be doing it, there should be some fun and informative stuff happening. So that's a prelude to something that's going to happen in about a month, ish. Yeah. So I love you folks, and stay safe. I can almost see something positive on the horizon, you know. And if you get the vaccine, which, you know, I hope you do, doesn't mean that you should stop doing all the stuff, and I'm not going to repeat all the stuff you guys know already. But anyway, I would be remiss if I didn't say be safe and take care of each other and have a great weekend, and I will see you guys on Tuesday. See you next Tuesday. Horror.